Jesus said, "Ask and it will be given to you. Search and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened for you." Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, every Friday from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m., we gather in our Trinity home, Karnad Mulki, for intercession. We pray for all your needs and intentions with faith in Jesus. We welcome you to join us with your prayer intentions. Let us pray together and seek God's help for all our needs. Come with your family. Remember, every Friday from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. in our Trinity home, Karnad Mulki. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all, my brothers and sisters. I warmly welcome you to this program called One God, One People. We have been listening to the Word of God and understanding that there is only one God, the Creator God, and that God, who is your God, my God, our God, is invisible, yet He is real. He does exist. And where He exists, we know. Today, let us go still more deeper to understand that God is truth. That there is absolute truth in the Lord. God is true. And this is what we listen to or hear in John's Gospel, chapter 3 and verse 33. It is written in chapter 3 of St. John's Gospel, verse 33. "Whoever has accepted His testimony has certified this, that God is true." There is God. The truth is this: God does exist. And this God is God of truth. Absolute truth. Yes, there is truth in Him, because He Himself is truth. God, who is truth, has come into this world to reveal the truth to the humanity. And that's why in John's Gospel, chapter 8 and verses 31 and 32, Jesus tells us, St. John's Gospel, chapter 8, verses 31 and 32, "Then Jesus said to the Jews who had believed in Him, 'If you continue in My word, you are truly My disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free.'" Listen once again. "Then Jesus said to the Jews who had believed in Him, 'If you continue in My word, you are truly My disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free.'" You will know the truth if you listen to My word, because there is truth in the word of God. God, who is truth. Yes, about this truth, it is written in this book of life, this good news, this holy gospel, a holy Bible. Yes, absolute truth is hidden. Because God, who is truth, about Him, only this book, the Holy Bible, will give us absolute truth. Because Jesus said, "If only you listen to My word, you will be My disciples, you will come to know the truth." Yes, the more we listen to the word of God, the more we read the word of God, my dear brothers and sisters, we will come to know the truth. And who is that truth? God is that truth. And that's why I have told you earlier, in my life, I came to know this truth just 15 years ago, when I was 33 years of age. So usually I tell people, yes, when I was 33, I was set free by John 3:33. And what is John 3:33? Just now what you heard. Yes, what you heard just now. It is written, John 3:33. "Whoever has accepted His testimony has certified this, that God is true." Yes, the truth is only in the scriptures. The truth is only in this holy Bible. The more we read the word, the more we'll come to know about the truth. And God is truth. as we have this beautiful, meaningful saying, Satyam eva jayate. What does it mean? God will prove that He is truth. How? Satyam eva jayate. Truth alone will triumph. Truth alone will win. Yet, when we know the truth, we are set free. No bondage. Nothing can bind you and me. Because the truth will set you free. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, I have been experiencing this freedom in the truth. I have been experiencing this freedom in the spirit during the last 15 years. Because through the word of God, God has set me free. The truth has set me free. God is truth. But God is invisible, I have said. Truth is invisible. But the truth did not remain invisible. We read in John's Gospel, God, who is truth, became visible. Visible in the person of Jesus. In John's Gospel, chapter 1 and verse 14. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen His glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. God, who is truth, God, who is invisible, becomes visible, and in Him who is visible, we have seen His glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Yes, Jesus is full of grace and truth. Jesus is the truth. And that's why He told His disciples, if you continue in My word, you will be truly My disciples and you will know the truth and the truth will set you free. Yes, in Jesus, the truth has become visible. And that's why in John's Gospel, chapter 18 and verses 35 onwards, if we read carefully, we will understand Jesus while speaking to Pilate. Yes, He very clearly says why He has come into this world. In John's Gospel, chapter 18, verses 35 and the following. Pilate replied, I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests have handed you over to Me. What have you done? Jesus answered, My kingdom is not from this world. If My kingdom were from this world, My followers would be fighting to keep Me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, My kingdom is not from here. Then Pilate asked Jesus. Pilate answered, You say that I am a king. For this I was born. Pilate asked him, So you are a king? Jesus answered, You say that I am a king. For this I was born. And for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to My voice. Jesus clearly answers to Pilate. Jesus answered, You say that I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to My voice. So Jesus came to this world to testify to the truth. And where is the truth? Everyone who belongs to the truth will listen to My voice. The truth is in the words of Jesus. Because He has come to testify to the truth. Jesus has come to tell us what is truth. Who is truth? Where is truth? That's why He says, everyone who belongs to the truth listens to My voice. But then Pilate asked Him, what is truth? Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, many of us in this world do not know what is truth. Many of us think that what I think is truth, what I do is truth. What is convenient for me is truth. No, my dear brothers and sisters, the truth is in the words of God. The truth is in the words of Jesus. The truth is hidden in these holy scriptures. And that's why I can give you this beautiful example. Yes, you have been to the court. And you know what is happening in the court. On behalf of two parties, the lawyers will argue. And to prove their argument true, yes, they bring in the witnesses. And before the person comes to give witness, he is made to take a vow. Or he is made to swear. If he is a Catholic or Christian, he is made to swear on the Holy Bible. If he is a Hindu, he is made to swear on the Holy Bhagavad Gita. If he is a Muslim, yes, he is made to swear on the holy book called Quran. But what do we say? Placing our hand on the holy scriptures, what everyone says, what I am going to say is the truth, nothing but the truth. In any language you say, that's what we say. Yes, even if you have to say in Hindi, jo kuch kahunga, sach ke bina kuch nahi kahunga. Even if you have to say in Kannada, heludala satyavanne heluttene, satyavannu bittu innu enu heludala. Jigidam santa, sat santa, sata shodhisane kiden sangana. In all the languages, yes, placing our hand on the holy scriptures, this is the promise that we make. This is the vow that we make. Why we have to place our hand on the holy scriptures? Just ask yourself, what is the meaning behind it? It signifies that there is truth in the holy scriptures. Yes, there is truth hidden in the holy scriptures. And therefore, in search of truth, where do we find it? In the holy scriptures. And that's why our father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhiji, yes, he was in search of truth. He was in search of truth. Where did he find it? He found it in the holy scripture. Yes, when he found the truth, he was set free. And knowing the truth, he made others free. He brought, yes, independence, freedom to our country. Therefore, I tell you, my dear brothers and sisters, one who is free only can lead others who are in bondage and set them free. If you yourself are in a bondage, you cannot set others free. Yes, only if you experience that freedom in the spirit, freedom in the truth, yes, you can lead others into that freedom. And that's why we sing that song. It's in Jesus that we find truth. It's in Jesus that we find redemption. It's in Jesus that we have our salvation. It's in Jesus that we have experienced life in abundance. And that's why we sing that song. Jesus sets me absolutely free. Died on Calvary to give me liberty. Jesus sets me absolutely free. Praise His name. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, I have been experiencing that freedom, total freedom, absolute freedom during the last 15 years. It's because of the Word of God. Yes, this Word of God has revealed the truth. This Word of God has, yes, brought the truth alive in my life. This Word of God has spoken absolutely about God who is truth. And that's why we read in 1 John chapter 5 and verse 20. In John's first letter, chapter 5 and verse 20. Just listen to the word carefully. It is written, and we know that the Son of God has come and has given us understanding so that we may know Him who is true. So who has given us that understanding about the truth? According to the Word of God, we know that the Son of God has come and has given us understanding so that we may know Him who is true. And we are in Him who is true. So when you and me, we know the truth, we are in Him who is true. We are united with that truth who is God. We are united with Jesus who came to witness to that truth. Yes, we are in Him who is true. His Son, Jesus Christ, is the true God and eternal life. So the truth will bind us with the truth. Truth will unite you and me in the fellowship of the truth. So the truth is in the scriptures. Truth is God. God who is truth, who is invisible, became visible in Jesus. And that's why in John's Gospel, chapter 14 and verse 6, Jesus will tell us, John 14 and verse 6, yes, it is written, Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. When we accept Jesus who is truth, yes, my dear brothers and sisters, we come to know the Father who is truth. And when we accept Jesus who is the truth, we have accepted Father who is the truth. And therefore, no one can come to the Father except through me. So, knowing truth, we need to know the truth in Jesus who is truth. And once we know that truth in Jesus, we have known the Father who is truth. Yes, and therefore, we are united with the truth, Father. God who is truth. Yes, that's why we sing that meaningful sloka. Asatoma Satgamaya. From asat, lead us to sat. Means from untrue, lead us to what is true. And it's the word of God. It's the word of God. Yes, which will lead us from untrue to the true. From asat to sat. And that's why once we know the truth, my dear brothers and sisters, we can live with everyone in peace, in love, in joy, in fellowship. Yes, understanding, in forgiveness, in caring for each other. Yes, in sharing all that we have for the good of others. Because once we know the truth, yes, this is possible. Therefore, God is truth and God became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace, full of truth, and He is none other than Jesus. So He is truth. But Jesus is not with us in person, in a human person, but He is with us in the form of spirit. And that spirit is also truth. We read in John's Gospel, chapter 14, verses 14, 15 to 17. Yes, John's Gospel, chapter 14, verses 15 to 17. If you love me, you will keep my commandments, and I will ask the Father, and He will give you another advocate to be with you forever. So another advocate to be with you forever. Who is this advocate? This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees Him nor knows Him. You know Him because He abides with you and He will be in you. When we have received the Spirit of truth, yes, my dear brothers and sisters, when we have received the Spirit of truth, world cannot receive Him, but you and me, we have received, because the world cannot see, the world cannot know. You know Him because He abides in you. Yes, you know Him because He is with you. So when the Spirit of truth is in us, when God's Spirit has come to live in us, to dwell in us, we have received the Spirit of truth. And the Spirit of truth is your companion, my helper, our advocate, who is going to be with us always, all throughout our life, to lead us into truth, to keep us in the truth, united in the fellowship of the truth. And when we are in the truth, we are set free. The truth has set us free. And that truth is made known to us through the Spirit of truth. We read in John's Gospel and chapter 16. Yes, John's Gospel, chapter 16 and verse 13. Again, very clearly it is written, when the Spirit of truth comes, He will guide you into all the truth. So who will lead you unto all the truth? When the Spirit of truth comes, He will guide you into all the truth. Who is the Spirit of truth? Spirit of the Father who is truth. Yes, is the Spirit of Jesus. The same Spirit who came upon Jesus. And therefore, Jesus could tell Pilate, yes, I have come to this world to testify to the truth. Because the Spirit of truth was upon Him. The Spirit of truth was upon Jesus. And Spirit of truth was leading Him into all the truth. So when the Spirit of truth comes, He will guide you into all the truth. For He will not speak on His own, but will speak whatever He hears. And He will speak, and He will declare to you the things that are to come. See, the Spirit of truth will come. He will not speak on His own. He will speak whatever He hears. And He will declare to you the things that are to come. The Spirit of truth will reveal the truth to us. He will glorify me because He will take what is mine and declare it to you. The Spirit of truth will not contradict what Jesus has said. Instead, the Spirit of truth will, yes, He will compliment. In the sense, what has been spoken, what has been revealed by Jesus, the same thing will be revealed to you and to me by the Spirit of truth. And that's why it is written, He will glorify me because He will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. For this reason, I said that He will take what is mine and declare it to you. Yes. Through the word of God, my dear brothers and sisters, the Spirit of truth will lead us unto all truth.
It is the spirit of truth.
Yes. There is no confrontation. There is no opposing views, but the spirit of truth will complement to what Jesus has said, what the scriptures are saying. Yes? In other words, what has been said about the Father who is the truth, or what is seen in Jesus, the life of Jesus, full of truth and grace. Yes, that's the same thing. The spirit of truth will lead to everyone, everywhere. In the same manner, there are no contradictions. There cannot be contradictions. Yes, because the spirit of truth will speak or reveal the truth to the humanity. And how is he going to reveal the truth? Yes, the spirit of truth will lead you and me through the word of God. And through the word of God, we'll come to know the truth. Ephesians chapter 6 and verse. Yes. Ephesians chapter 6 and verses 17 and the following. Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 17. Yes, take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the spirit, which is the word of God. The spirit of truth will take the word of God as sword and reveal the truth to us. Yes. Once you are anointed with the power of the Holy Spirit, yes, everyone will be revealed the same truth through the word. It will not contradict, and it cannot contradict. And if he is contradicting, he is not the right spirit. Yes, because in 1 John chapter 4 verses 1 to 3, you can test the spirit, whether he is the spirit of truth or whether he is the spirit who is confusing or bringing about divisions. You can very well test it. It is written in 1 John chapter 4 verses 1 to 3. Beloved, do not believe every spirit, but test the spirits to see whether they are from God. For many false prophets have gone out into the world. By this you know the spirit of God. By this you know the spirit of God. Every spirit that confesses that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is from God. Every spirit that confesses that Jesus Christ has come into the flesh is from God. And every spirit that does not confess Jesus is not from God. So how do we know which is the right spirit? Which is the spirit of truth? Yes, the spirit of truth, as we already heard, the spirit of truth will come and guide you into all the truth. He will not speak in his own. He will declare what I have spoken to you, Jesus said. So, the spirit of truth will come to testify that Jesus has come in flesh. That Jesus has come to testify to the truth. That Jesus is one God. In him we are united, and through him we are united with the Father. So, this is the truth revealed by the spirit of truth. Any other spirit is contradicting this truth is not the right spirit, my dear brothers and sisters. Therefore, let us not get confused. Because, yes, St. Paul, writing to the Colossians, he has said, do not be just carried away by the philosophies of this world. In Colossians chapter 2 verse 8, see to it that no one takes you captive through philosophy and empty deceit, according to the human tradition, according to the elemental spirits of the universe, and not according to Christ. Elemental spirits of the universe. Yes, they are confusing spirits. They are misguiding spirits. Only the spirit of truth will lead us unto all truth. And therefore, through the word of God, my dear brothers and sisters, yes, we are here to witness to that truth, to testify that truth, so that all of us become, yes, the children of one God. And there will be one God and one people. And that has been our work. And that's what we are intending to do. And that's what we have read in Ephesians chapter 4, verses 1 to 4. Or Ephesians chapter 4 verses 4 to 6, it is written, there is one body and one spirit, just as you are called to the one hope of your calling. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. So one spirit, the guiding spirit, the inspiring spirit, the comforting spirit, the consoling spirit, the spirit of truth, who is going to lead us unto all truth. Yes, may the grace of that Father, wish truth be with you always. May the love of Jesus be filled in your hearts always. May the fellowship of the Holy Spirit always be there among you, so that you and your entire family, yes, believing in one true God, will experience life in abundance. Yes, in Jesus' name I pray and bless you. May the mighty God, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit bless you and your family now and forever and ever. Amen. 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 Jesus said, ask and it will be given to you. Search and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened for you. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, every Friday from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m., we gather in our Trinity Home Karnad Mulki for intercession. We pray for all your needs and intentions with faith in Jesus. We welcome you to join us with your prayer intentions. Let us pray together and seek God's help for all our needs. Come with your family. Remember, every Friday from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m., in our Trinity Home, Karnad Mulki.